There's plenty of green at Sweetgreen in Palo Alto, but none in the cash register. That's because customers can't pay with cash. They only accept app or credit.
I think it's pretty great.
It's a pain in the rear.
It's an experiment Sweetgreen calls the future of retail. They say it speeds up service and creates a safer environment for employees. And Sweetgreen's not alone. In addition to a handful of restaurants in San Francisco and New York, most airlines stopped accepting cash for in-flight purchases years ago, and the country of Sweden is largely cashless.
This is part of a larger trend.
Christina Tetro of Consumers Union says going cashless can be lucrative.
Cash is expensive, it's time-consuming, and there's shrink, and that's the loss due to, you know, either cash mishandling or even theft.
And it appears fewer people are carrying cash. According to Bankrate, more than two-thirds of consumers carry $50 or less on a regular basis, and 9% don't carry any cash at all. In fact, some customers here are so used to paying electronically, they were unaware of the policy. But Tetro says there are some drawbacks to going cashless, like excluding the 24 million unbanked Americans.
Effectively, 7% of the population is not welcome there.
It feels almost a little elitist to me.
And those who pay with plastic tend to spend more. It's estimated 12 to 18% more, which may be costly for consumers, but good for business.
I got extra chicken, and I didn't think twice about the cost of it. Normally I would.
Julie Watts, KPIX 5.
Sweetgreen tells us it's learning from the experiment and is evaluating feedback from its customers.